Hey guys, how's it going? So today's video is gonna be fairly quick, but this is kind of part two of our moon garden planting series, I guess. Know that it's going to be an actual series, but I'm getting ready to plant two more varieties of things in the moon garden that I wanted to show you because they're both very pretty. I have had experience with one of these in different variety form though. So this is an Achillea or yarrow is the common name. I love the ferny feathery foliage that it has, and last year I planted firefly amethyst, firefly sunshine, and firefly peach sky, I think is what it's called. Planted all three of those and they were beautiful. They all did really well. And the thing I liked about them was even when their blooms were aged, they still were really pretty. In fact, I used some aged or completely spent blooms in quite a number of my arrangements in the fall. So I really like that they have that versatility, that they look good even when they're not like in prime bloom. So this one though is called Firefly Diamond. See if I can get it to focus there. It grows about 24 to 48 inches tall and up to like 30 or 32 inches wide, maybe even a little bit wider. I'm gonna probably be putting mine closer together though, because I want them to be kind of a mass where I'm putting them. And they've got these kind of disc-like, see if it'll focus on it, disc-like sprays of white blooms. Now these are just starting to open, so they'll get quite large, and I like how they rise above the foliage right here, but they do have a very upright kind of shape when they grow. They're not like super like wide and squat, if that makes sense. They're more tall. So I think that these will be a really pretty addition, not to mention the fact that they're incredibly tough. So 3 through 8, I think, zones. Zone 3 through 8, they just do really well in a lot of different conditions. They don't like rich soil, so you want to plant these in areas that are more tough for you to grow things in, which is great. And then they are more drought resistant once they're established than a lot of other perennials. So I think this is gonna be a really fun addition. I have 7 of these to plant over in the moon garden. And then the next one is this right here. This is a windflower or anemone called White Splendor. See the tag right there? I planted some of these around the base of one of our arbors near our chicken coop. I have a wisteria going over the top of it, and these planted below. And they are beautiful. They are not, like I always think of anemones as being super aggressive, and these don't seem to be that way. Of course, I haven't had mine in for that long. But I think that even if these want to spread themselves around a little bit, it's totally fine. And these are a spring bloomer, so I'm planning on planting these together. So this is going to be my front layer, this is going to be my back layer, this is going to be my spring bloomer, this will be my summer bloomer. And that's really important, especially in this moon garden application, when I want there to be interesting blooms all the time. I want to make sure that I've got things that'll bloom in all the seasons. And this one grows, and see how much I can remember about it, 4 to 6 inches tall, 6-inch spacing, and they like part to full sun. So I think that these two will both do really, really well over there. And I just like take a second to appreciate that flower. Isn't that the sweetest thing? So I think what I wanna do, it's a very sunny day today and it's very full sun where these are going. We'll head over there. I'll give you kind of a little look at where these are going, because you will recognize it from the first part. If you watch the first moon garden planting video, you'll see some of the new plants that just went in, and then we'll get them all planted. So let's head over there. So we're on the far end of the west side where I just got through planting the White Wands Veronica, Daisy May Daisies. There is a red tip Norway spruce right here. There's also the Overdum Calamagratis that I just planted, and the Blue Kazoo Spirea, which it is starting to leaf out now. There are fresh leaves coming. There's a lot of fresh at the base. I'm actually kind of glad I was toying with the idea of cutting it back, and I might still do that depending on how it looks once it's fully leafed out. But I'm glad I didn't, because I can see what size it is at maturity. That's how big it gets. So it makes it very easy to plan for what to plant around it. So I'm starting the drift of anemones right in front of the spirea, and it'll just kind of swoop in front of the diamond, firefly diamond yarrow right here. And I decided to just go with 5 of them in this location for right now. I think that'll be nice, and it'll leave us enough space to naturally put in a smallish kind of round evergreen, I think,
right in this area here.
And I'm honestly kind of going about this whole thing a little bit odd and a little bit different than I normally do. Because when I start a new area, typically I do trees and evergreens in any hardscape, which we did do. You know, we did the brick pathway, we've got the red point maples, the arborvitas, the urns, the boxwoods, we've got kind of that structure in place. But then typically after that, I start in with bigger things like shrubs. I don't have a whole lot of that going on in this area, but even though I'm doing a lot of perennials and then I will be doing annuals, most of those are bumped toward the front of the beds anyway, and that's where these things are going. If I have to shift things around, that's just gonna be the way it is. So anyway, I'm gonna get all these planted and then we'll take a look. And there they are all planted. I did end up planting the last two right in here. I just tucked them in just to continue that same texture a little bit further down. And I do think it'll be nice to have that different bloom structure, because here we have a really spiky long bloom, a really bold kind of heavy bloom, and then this one will be more of a light disc. I don't know how to describe it better than that, but they're very, very different, which I think is important. Then we have our anemones, which these will probably not be blooming at the same time the anemones will be last year, because these perennials have been forced a little early to bloom. They've been in our greenhouse. So typically, like in the next years, we'll see these bloom first and then the rest of these things will start in. So we've got the five right there. They've all been watered in and I just think it's gonna be really pretty. Almost kind of has a Queen Anne's lace vibe to it. And I think I could honestly skip the biotone on the yarrow at least, because it doesn't like rich soil. It doesn't like to be over-fertilized, kind of like sedum. I never fertilize sedum. I don't use starter fertilizer and I don't fertilize them on a regular basis like I do any of my other perennials. So I could have skipped that. I just used like a pinch though in the hole and they should be okay. And this area does stay a little bit on the wet side. So I'm going to keep my eye on the yarrow and make sure that they stay happy, but I do need to complete the very last thing that I have to do after every planting tour. I need to go get rid of the soil, and I get asked this all the time, like what I do with the soil I put in the cans, because what I like to do when I plant is scoot the mulch aside, then I dig my hole and I put all of the soil, or most of it that comes out of the hole, right in the can, so that it doesn't make an enormous mess everywhere. And then I use some of that soil from the can back in the hole just to make sure that the root balls are tamped in really tightly with no air pockets. But whatever's left over, I actually take up into this front pasture. So we'll go do that really quick. What do you think of the new plants, buddy? Hi, sweetie. You're a good boy. You wanna go out to the pasture with us, buddy? And then with our empty cans, we are saving them. We save them in the barn until we have a nice big load of them, and then we figure out where we can go recycle them. So that's typically what we do, and we'll probably include that in a video later on in the season when we've got a good enough batch to take them in, just because you guys ask quite often what we do with all of the extra stuff we end up with.
Oh, would you look at these? While we're up here, we should just take a quick look. Look at how pretty these containers are. And the tiny little daffodils. What in the world? I don't remember planting those. I remember planting these. Those are like fairy daffodils. So cute. Are there any more? Oh, those daffodils are fragrant though. So we're just on the outside of the property. We used to pour all the extra dirt into a ditch that ran along the fence right here. And we were just kind of like trying to make it level with everything else. We hadn't even made it that far, which is surprising with the amount of things we plant. We made it to maybe like right here. But now that this has been all leveled up, cleaned up, and it looks really nice, I'm just going to pour the rest of the dirt kind of where we've got extra right here. And that will be flattened out later. And I'm sure I'll have, like, I've got plenty of space just to pour dirt anywhere, honestly. I could just dump it right here and it would be fine. Oh, and kind of side note, this is the little pile of sand that they use to do our brick walkway. I wanted to show you guys what it looks like. It's not like actual sand. It's like little tiny pebbles. So that's what they use as the top layer that the bricks get set on. So they like smooth it out and set the bricks on. But like if you get down in here, there's kind of some sand in it too. Like it leaves behind a sandy residue. Kind of interesting. I don't even know where they get this stuff. First time I've ever seen it. So that's it for today's video. Didn't do a whole lot, but it does feel good to get those plants in the ground, and I think they're gonna be really pretty where they're at. And I just wanna document everything that we do in the new space over there in the moon garden. I think the very next project we're gonna work on is back behind me in the newly plowed up area on the new property. I'm so excited. There's just so many exciting things going on right now. I'm just loving it. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we will see you in the next one. Bye.